Then all these remote sensing techniques which are used in a forestry is that forest non-forest segregation directly, forest type mapping, forest cover density, then gregarious forest distribution, that means forest species distribution, then growing stock estimations, tree height, deforestation, forest and forest degradation, then change detection, biomass, species distribution, modeling we can do, habitat, wildlife habitat, monitoring the analysis, forest fire, shifting cultivation. There are many studies are there which we can do using remote sensing and geospatial technology. But today, we will be discussing mostly on growing stock estimations. This is what our topic is. Let's come to the point. Then, when we talk about growing stock, I understand many of you are already students of forestry and also faculties of forestry, so you know what the growing stock is. So it is nothing but the volume of all living trees in a particular area, in a particular reserve forest, maybe compartment or maybe a division, maybe a state. So what is the total forest growing timber available in that particular area? That is how you, when you calculate together, that become the growing stock. So growing stock is also always estimated based on a particular measurement, which is normally we call that GBH, girth at breast height. That is also is measured for a tree. So when we define a tree, it is always considered as any tree diameter more than 30 centimeter girth is considered as tree. So all this growing stock, when we calculate, we always calculate trees growing in a particular area above 30 centimeter girth. So the subsequent slides will be talking all the whenever we are talking about the tree or growth or growing stock, it will always refer to the trees pertaining to above 30 centimeter diameter class only. So growing stock, why it is important? Because mainly this is a primary input for preparation of forest working plan. So all of you know what the forest working plan is. Forest working plan is nothing but it is a management plan for the forest departments for a 10 years forest management plan. Means if any forest, when they are going to manage it, they have to make a proper plan for 10 years. Every year, what will be the which area they are going to extract, what will be the their, where they are going to plant, go for a replantation, where will be this what is called a thinning. All these plans has to be prepared and has to be approved by the Ministry of Forest and Forest Environment and Forest and Climate Change by Government of India. Until and unless MOEFCC approved, a working plan is not valid for the department. So this is very important. And for this forest working plan, this actual status of the growing stock is very important. Because until and unless you know what is the amount or what is the money you have in your bank, you can't make a plan for your 1 year or 2 years duration. You should know what is fund you have with you. So that's why this growing stock is very important for the forest departments, and it is a primary input for the forest working plan. Growing stock is equally important to understand the productivity of a forest, because it is used to evaluate and monitor the commercial potential of a forest. For timber, for fuel wood, or whatever you say, and for even harvesting also, growing stock, extending growing stock is very important. Then important information on growing stock is also essential for understanding the ecological dynamics and the productive capacity of forest stands, and also allows the managers to the ability to manage stands within the limit of sustainability as defined by their dynamics of the growth. So the commercial value is derived from the total growing stock and constitute the proportion of the growing stock that is represented by commercial tree species fulfilling minimum criteria for quality, dimension, and sometimes age as well as development stages. So this is very important. And this also growing stock leads to quantification of biomass and carbon stored, because this once you know what is the timber value available, based on that you can convert this to biomass. Of course, this will be only tree biomass. Then also, once you know the biomass, then converting them to carbon is easy, because every country we need to report to IPCC about the net net carbon and greenhouse gas emissions to emissions. So this is very important parameters which you need to evaluate every year. If you see the world's growing stock is estimated as almost 434 billion maybe cubic meters, which is of which around 30% are found in the South America. In India, first survey of India generating information on growing stock since 1965, because that means growing stock is not a new thing for us. And the total growing stock in India is estimated to be around 5,915.76 million cubic meters, with an average growing stock of 58.46 cubic meter per hectare, that as State of Forest Report 2019. This is what this, as per FSR 2019, this is distribution of growing stock in all the states and union territories of India. If you see the Arunachal Pradesh, there is total growing stock is almost 5,533 million cubic meter. However, the growing stock per hectare is around 89. So almost say 89 cubic meter per hectare. In India, if you see the statistics, how highest growing stock available per hectare is in Jammu and Kashmir. And then the ranges follows from almost from 30 to almost is a, yeah, it is a 24 to almost 144. And this SFR State of Forest Report also defined this growing stock available within the forest as well as trees outside the forest too. And also this the SFR also given the details about this dominant species, around 10 species. It is stating that Surya Robusta is dominating the growing stock. Almost 10% of the total country's forest is having the Surya Robusta, followed by Tectona grandis. That's how the statistics is. Now, when we talk about this growing stock, this is what this FSI is doing. Now, when we measure or when we calculate the estimate the growing stock, we need fill-in information. Because until and unless you have a field measurement, you can't do any modeling. Yesterday, I think Professor Joshi has mentioned, without sensing, remote sensing has no sense. Means, if until and unless you sense on the ground, that is ground truth, if you do, remote sensing can give you any accurate information. Sorry. So, we need to do the actual ground measurement, particularly for this type of estimates when we are talking about grounds, growing stock and any other few estimates. This has to be substantiated by the ground measurement first. So that is what, without the detailed measurement, we can't understand the potential of growth contained within a single tree species or even a population.